രാജശ്രീ വെങ്കിട്ടരമണ് 130 വാക്ക് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ഷോർട്ട് ആൻഡ് സ്പീഡ് ഡിക്റ്റേഷൻ. ഇത് 40-ാമത്തെ നമ്പറാണ് ഞാൻ വായിക്കുന്ന ഡിക്റ്റേഷൻ. കഴിഞ്ഞ എല്ലാ ഡിക്റ്റേഷനും നിങ്ങൾ 2-3 പ്രാവശ്യമെങ്കിലും മിനിമം പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്തിരിക്കണം, ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലേക്ക് ട്രാൻസ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്തിരിക്കണം. ഓക്കെ. ഇറ്റ് ഗീവ്സ് മീ ഗ്രേറ്റ് പ്ലഷർ ടു ബി ഹിയർ ആൻഡ് ടു നെയിം ദ ന്യൂ ക്യാമ്പസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി ആഫ്റ്റർ വൺ who has molded our entire nation. It was our previous president, Dr. Radhakrishnan, who said that an Indian is not merely a person who is born in India, but he who stands for the great principles which have personified India through the ages. That is why we are proud that we have a father of nation, a man who had identified himself not only with the great ideals of the nation, but also in a very great practical sense with the aspirations of the common people of the land. He realized that these high ideals could not be attained or even understood if people were denied their basic needs and rights. So it is, although I am personally not very much in favor of institution being named great people, I consider it very appropriate that an agricultural university's campus should bear Mahatma Gandhi's name. I sincerely hope that all those who came to study here will always keep Mahatma Gandhi's ideals before them, which means not only in believing in some of his ideals, but also in identifying themselves with the common man. India is a country of great poverty. It has also been stated that the country is rich, but many people live here in great poverty. As the Pro-Chancellor Wright state today, science and technology have given us not only the knowledge to produce more food, but also tremendous resources of trained man power. Not only can we produce the known varieties of food and food grains with modern methods of farming, but we have also the knowledge to produce new kinds of food that we would nourish mankind. All our thinking has to be revolutionized now. Up to now, the question was looked at from the point of view that there was not enough to go round. Today, for the first time, we face the future with confidence. We are in a position to say that we can feed everybody in the world, provided the resources of the world are in the right manner, provided the knowledge of science and technology is utilized for constructive purposes and for meeting the needs and demands of those who have so far been underprivileged and have been denied their basic rights for adequate food and basic necessities of life. This was the basis of our freedom movement in India. We never looked at freedom merely from the point of view of a political change. The social and economic battle, that it is not yet won. It is only the political battle that has been won. But the problem of giving the economic and social justice to our people is still to be faced. There are vast forces which always arise against any kind of revolutionary move, even though the political revolution was a non-violent one. It was a unique move used by Mahatma Gandhi. We tried to bring about social and economic changes by a process of education, persuasion, and cooperation. But we can say that we will be self-sufficient in a couple of years in food grains. Dear reader, you are now in midterm holidays. We suggest our readers not to waste the vacation in mere loitering here and there or visiting films. We therefore suggest that our readers should spend their vacation usefully, as time is precious and priceless. Time will never reverse, nor will it come back to me for our convenience sake. This once lost is lost forever. Hence, we earnestly suggest that you had to fix up yourself entirely for studies. You should study 8-10 hours a day. Try to understand and retain the subject matter in which you are weak. Revise whatever portion that has been covered in your classes so far. By the time the college reopens, you must be thorough with the